The ideas took hold gradually with many people that this theory, this Yang-Mills theory, with asymptotic freedom, that is to say, with the renormalization group having the fixed point at the opposite end from quantum electrodynamics, so that it was at short distances that particles became nearly free rather than at long distances. This idea took hold. It would explain the Bjorken, Feynman, and so on idea, that it would explain the experiments, which agreed with that idea. And it might also, at the other end, at the long distance, small momentum transfer end, where apparently the interaction was strong, might explain the confinement. There might be a potential that grew bigger and bigger and bigger at large distances and would confine all colored objects just the way we wanted them confined. So that whole point of view seemed very nice. And as I mentioned, with the work of Polyakov and company and at Hooft on instantons, the problem of the fourth or the ninth pseudoscalar meson was fixed up. And objections to this theory then would gradually melted away. In 1976, I christened it quantum chromodynamics, using the Greek word for color, because the color variable was what gave rise to the forces. And that name is stuck, QCD, in addition to QED.